Historical evidence takes many shapes and forms, including but not limited to written evidence, such as a newspaper article, a death certificate, or visual evidence, such as pictures, representational art, or political cartoons. Each form of evidence requires students to employ a specific set of literacy skills. Literacy skills include sourcing documents, contextualizing documents, close reading of the document, and collaboration between sources.
A primary source is it's a document that was written at that time, and it could be anything like a picture, a letter, a poem, or a song, music. And it's valuable because it was written that time, the exact time that the event was occurring. And you can analyze the important details to find out what happened in the past.
We look at a variety of sources that regard the event that we're studying. And by looking at the sources, we kind of like see how the people there actually felt, like see the different perspectives on the view. And Mr. Lesh kind of makes it seem like we're not just learning about people who did something. We're learning about, like, they were actually people. They weren't just events. They're people, and they felt, and they are almost exactly the same as we are.
Make sure that your documents fit the kids, and don't try to mold your kids to the documents. Especially for middle school, there's a lot of the primary sources are very tough for them. So to use resources that you already have in your curriculum, if you already have a document, you can reshape that document. You don't need to create your own. You can modify.
This one is by John Doyle. Okay.
So I see Philadelphia. So someone moved to the Americas from...
Okay, exactly? He landed in Philadelphia, so he probably... Let's see where he came from. Okay, what does that one say?
John Curtis.
Okay, so that's a separate one?
Yeah.
What's yours say, Noah?
John Curler and Henry Miller.
Can I see this?
Are you having trouble with Laura Dunbar's perspective?
Well, kind of. I can't really find his perspective out of the whole proclamation.
Okay. So you can't tell what side he's on?
Yeah.
Did you see right here where it says to defeat people that commit treason, to bring all traitors and their supporters to justice? So who is he talking about? Who are the people that are committing treason?
The colonists.
Yeah. So what does he want to do to the colonists?
They want to defeat them.
Yeah. So whose side is he on?
So he's on the British, and he's trying to get the colonists to behave.
Exactly.
UMBC Center for History Education has organized fantastic resources for you to use to create your own history labs. This is the path to efficiently locate source documents that will bring your history lab to life.